I'm going to try and paint a perspective of horticulture within a retail landscape such as Coles or any large supermarketing retail landscape. And I'm going to focus on the customer and what the customer's telling us and why that's driving us to work with our suppliers, our produce growers and producers in the way that we do. I'll be talking about some specific growers that we've worked closely with, but by no means would that be the totality of the great grower population that we're working with. So those of you who might be in the room who think, well, why didn't you mention me, please forgive that. I've done the best I can. I left Costa's out because I had their own moment. So I wasn't going to do the normal stuff about Coles and what Coles is, 700 stores, 14 million customers, whatever all that is. I was just going to talk more about Coles and its positioning from the point of view of the customer, particularly in the area of fresh produce. So inevitably in fresh produce, it's an Australia first sourcing policy, but it's actually an Australia first sourcing policy for our private label offer in across all categories that we sell. But 96% of our fresh produce is grown in this country. We can now expand that sort of great produce story across into our frozen categories, and we're looking at our canned categories as well to try and bring as much as we can back into this country because that matters to our customers. We work with around 350 fresh produce suppliers directly. They're the people that pack the product for us, but sitting behind them will be thousands and thousands of growers all over the country who we also work very closely with. And we're actually very committed to the horticultural and agricultural industries in Australia, because not least because we've got so many people working in those industries that are suppliers to us, but because actually a third of our own workforce, our own team of 100,000 people, live and work in rural Australia. And so this whole agricultural landscape is really, really important to us employing and retaining and motivating our own team. Sort of central to, well, absolutely central to what we try to do and what we believe we do relatively well is listening to our customers. And we spend a huge amount of time talking to customers about what matters to them. Now, we've heard a number of presentations today about how fickle that can be and how customers can talk one thing and behave in quite another way. And we're lucky in that we can actually analyse both those behaviours because we sit at the front end. The customers come into our store. We can talk to them remotely, we can talk to them with product, we can sample product with them, but we can also watch their shopping behaviours. And we can do that through our own sales data, but more importantly, probably our flybys data, where we get some very, very detailed information out of those loyalty cards around how people from various demographics and various backgrounds with various family sizes and various occupations shop and what they do under certain situations when they come into our store. And that helps us tailor our offer, and we work very closely with that data back up the chain with our suppliers to try and make sure we're tailoring the offer in a way that is beneficial to us, obviously our customers, and therefore to our producers, our growers. So what do they tell us? So we have a reasonably good understanding about customers as a consequence of all this, and they tell us that, well, we know that the fresh food proposition in supermarkets is what determines whether or not a customer comes into the supermarket or not. So that centre plate protein and the fruit and veg, or the veg particularly for their dinner occasion, will determine where they go to shop. And they'll only go where they're confident in the quality that they're going to get. Now, we know that only somewhere around half of the customers that come in our store, and that's 14 million people a week, are buying fresh fruit and veg in our stores. So the opportunity is massive from our perspective. To grow that business and to sell more fresh fruit and vegetables to our customers. What's more important is if when those customers come in who are prepared to buy it with us, if they can't see what they want, they'll leave. And when they leave, from our perspective, they'll take their entire shop with them. And you will sometimes walk around a supermarket and see a basket abandoned in the aisle. That's very rarely because of the checkouts. That's nearly always because they'd lost interest in the shop because there was too many things they couldn't get. And there'll be some items that if they can't get, bananas would be a classic example, if they can't get it, then they're just going to leave. If they come to the store for bananas, doesn't matter how good the rest of the store is, if you haven't got bananas or the bananas they want, they're going to walk out of the store and they'll leave the rest of their shop behind. We know in the fresh produce area there's four really key things that matter to customers. Freshness, and I'll come and talk a little bit about what that means, because what you think freshness means isn't necessarily what they think it means. Provenance, you know, this whole credence, however you want to describe it, this whole where and how it's been grown and produced. What it does, and these two trends that we see emerging with customers that are critical, that of health and that of convenience. So in terms of freshness, customers mean a lot of different things in this space. They want to know where it was grown, how it was grown, how far it went. Interestingly, when you get into further process, the longer the shelf life, the fresher they think it is, which is kind of completely opposite to what we would think it would be. The fact that it's Australian and, more importantly, local within Australia to a region they recognise also tells them, or they believe, that gives them a fresher product. It might not necessarily be the case, but that's what they believe. So for us, what's that done to our business model and how we've changed the way we operate over the last 5 years? Well, fundamentally what it's meant is we've tried to shorten that chain. We've tried to get as close to the grower as we can, to buy directly, to move it quickly so that we can get it into our stores in the freshest possible state. Our aspiration, I think, or certainly from a quality perspective, my aspiration would be that, you know, we're sort of farm to store in 48 hours. That would be your aspiration, where the product is in season and local. And, you know, we try very hard to do that, and there is a number of issues that we face in the chain to do it. But by going directly to the suppliers, not only does it help with that freshness cue for the customer, but it's obviously giving greater security of supply. It's actually generating greater level of income along the chain, for some people, certainly for the grower, because there's less middlemen between us and the grower. And it gives us the opportunity to talk directly with the grower about opportunities for innovation, opportunities to close the seasonal gaps, all the sorts of things that particularly Costas were talking about earlier. It's important to customers to know where and how their product is grown. We've seen, we don't need to talk any more about raspberries, I don't think, but I mean, everybody is asking us how and where the product is being grown. And so we've been doing a lot of work over the last couple of years, particularly with our tier one growers, our key growers, to understand not only where they're growing their product, but how they're growing their product. And that's allowing us to obviously monitor and keep an eye on it, but also to report and to pick up those really great individual stories that we can then use to communicate to customers through the website, through Unpack, through in-store, through other social media outlets, etc. Stories about things going on farm, which help them connect them with the farm, and that gives them the confidence and the trust that's important. Some quick examples of things we've done, starting at the very processed end. So working with particularly one of our suppliers of bagged salads, a huge amount of work shelf life increase. We've managed to get 2 more days life into this product, all of which we've given to the customer through varietal changes, through harvest changes, through investment in different types of washing equipment, through gas flushing, through a whole raft of different technologies. And that not only has given a fresher and better quality product, but it's also reduced the waste. So there's an economic benefit all the way through the chain. Working locally with growers to reduce the amount of imports is also important to us, and we've got a couple of examples, one here of onions, where through work on varietal development, geographic location, we've been able to stop the imports. We achieved that last year in 2014. Another one here where glass houses, primarily focusing on tomatoes, then expanded out into capsicums, flavour right down in Gippsland in Victoria. Not only have they now got a wider crop variety, so they've reduced their risk, they employ more people, and again, we get local product rather than having to import. We've had some really innovative, this is probably the most innovative producer environment that we've got, down in South Australia, where we've got a very, very unique setup running with Sundrop to do with tomato growing, using desalinated water, solar energy, zero pesticide. Quite a long, protracted process to get into this partnership with this organisation, and a 10-year contract now to grow these products for Coles. Matt Hood up in Rugby Farms, green bean producer, again, working on his methodology of growing and picking and packing and sorting to give us that consistent, reliable quality, less defect in the pack, and therefore more repeat purchase and more confidence for the customer. These are all really, really key things in driving like-for-like growth in the category of produce from our perspective. And this health and convenience trend, and I think this is the one that's probably got the greatest area to grow. When I joined Coles in 2006, we had around about 3 bagged salad lines, and it would take what we would call a quarter of a module. A module's about a metre wide, fixture in the store, and it would take about a quarter of that module, a couple of shelves. We now have in our sort of biggest stores, I think three or four modules of prepared bagged salad. The growth has been absolutely incredible. We can't get enough varietal variation. We actually can't get enough volume. It's been a massive success story for the industry involved in producing that product, and that's because customers are looking for this convenience quality option, and they are willing to pay for it as long as we can consistently deliver it. And that consistency is really, really important, because the more you value add in the product, the less tolerant customers will be of defects. They'll accept a defect on the primary product and cut it out, but they won't accept it in the bag of salad. And so you have to be really, really focused on your engineering and your quality management and things like that as you get up the chain. Clearly, the low GI has been a huge success, and then, you know, portion control, treating, snacking, these are all, as we heard with the Purina, these are all trends that it's really important to look to and to think about in terms of a future growth. So a quick rattle through, happy to chat to anybody after the event is over, but for us, we see produce, there's nothing more important. The meat team won't like me saying this, but there's nothing more important in our stores than the fresh produce offer. It's key to bringing that footfall. It's key to building that trust. We've done a huge amount with a great number of fantastic growers around the country to get to the position we're in today. It's given us double-digit growth year on year for the last 5 years in that category, and we see no reason, irrespective of the export market, for that not to be a continued success story. So I thank all of you who've helped us with that, and I'll leave it there. Thank you.